Hey peoples, Not the Cool Mom here. So I'm coming to you with another Fresh Off the Hook video. I've been quite busy. This past week I was actually on vacation, so everywhere I went I actually had my little bag with me with my yarn, working on different projects. So I'm going to show you what I've been carrying around. So I don't know if you can see in there. Oops. I have a whole bunch of cotton. And actually some thread too. So I've just been carrying these colors around in this bag I got over a year ago. But any time that I've had in between activities with the kids and shopping and doctor's appointments and all those types of things that you do when you try to cram it into your vacation time, I've taken my yarn and hook. So I have a good bit to show you. So I'll start off with my granny squares. So here's one. Here's another. I've only done three so far, and then I had one that I messed up on that ended up being smaller. So if you see the difference, it's smaller. But I had already cut my yarn, so I was like, well, I'm going to keep going, and I might use it for something else. But I haven't decided if I'm going to do a pillow or maybe even a blanket. And then I had the idea of actually, after blocking them, framing them, because it kind of goes with the colors I have in my house. But just framing, say, one per one block per frame and just hang it on the wall. So I haven't decided on that. If I do a pillow or a blanket, I have a lot more to go, but they were easy to do in between weights. Then I've done, Then I've done two hats. So here's the first one in green. First one right there. Let's see if I can adjust my camera again. And then I did another one in blue. And for all of these, I've been using cotton yarn. So here's the same one in blue. It's like a denim. Mesh hats. Then I did another granny square, all purple. It's a big one. And after I finished, I said, oh, I'll do a second one and just make a bag out of it. And let me show you my second one. So you see how big this one is. This one was a little uptight that day, apparently. Turned out so much tighter. So I put the two of them together and you see how much smaller the other one is. So I don't think any amount of blocking is going to stretch that out. So I will have to do another one. So what I may do is actually use the smaller one on a pillow and then make a larger one to make the bag. Then I went to the craft store and I saw these little styrofoam blocks and I decided that I wanted to do something with it. So I actually created a pincushion. So I took the styrofoam block, so that's what's underneath, and I did leave the the plastic on it because you know how styrofoam, if you pick at it, it starts to come up. And because I'm going to use this as a pincushion, I know, you know, you'll be putting pins in the same spot. So I decided to do it kind of like the ground. So this is the dirt, and then here's the grass, and did a little scalloping on the edges for the grass. And then the roses I came up with on my own, and the leaves, I will put the link for the pattern for those. I'll put the link for the pattern for everything that I used the pattern on. But then on top, I have two little flowers. All of this is made out of cotton. And this is I guess like a little version of a rose. And this one, I don't know what it would be, but I made those up as I went along. But I think it turned out pretty cute. And I wasn't sure if I wanted to add more flowers, but then I didn't want to take away from the overall appearance. So I'm not sure. If I add more flowers, I'll bring it back again in the video. If not, there's my end result. Then I did bunting, as you can see above me, using yarn and these little foam, I don't know what they're called, foam cutouts. I got these from Target in the little dollar section that they have. And then I just took some yarn that I had scraps of, and I just chained all the way through and added it, and then that created the bunting that's above my head. And then I have some more that I hadn't put on the wall yet, and we use that for one of our birthday dinners that we have for the kids. And I thought it was cute and inexpensive. And then I think this is the last bit. Yeah, then I started making little bows, and I think that they're really cute, and it's very simple. So we have one bow in green, one in brown, and you see the brown is smaller than the green one. And then I got started on a red one, and all it is single crochet back and forth, and then you just fold it to create the bow. So the red one will be larger than the green one. And so I think I'm going to do these in quite a few colors. And I haven't decided if I'm just going to attach them to bobby pins or if I'm actually going to attach them to a clip. But my daughter already wants to put them in her hair. So I do have some, I don't know what it's called, the pins like you'd put on your clothing. So I might add those also. But I thought it was very cute and extremely simple to make. And I will give you the link, of course, where I got all these ideas. I've been kind of catching up on a lot of blogs, and creative juices are flowing based off what people have done. And so it's been a fun vacation in that sense. But if you're interested in checking out the other Fresh Off the Hook family members, please feel free to check out the links below. And I will see you later on. Keep your hooks up. Enjoy the days that you're given. And have a blessed day.